Attention. This is a message from the LCC Content Control Committee. Due to popular request, we declare this episode of LCCTV as cringe reduced. Enjoy the episode.
Hi, I'm Cynthia Qin.
And I'm Jarret Jacobs, coming to you from behind a desk where I can safely keep my shirt untucked. Not today, Mr. Hotate. Not today.
Our top story today, an interview with Tracey Deer.
That's right, our very own Vivienne Webster sat down with Tracey and asked her some of your burning questions about the television industry.
Unfortunately, she was unable to answer the following questions.
A. How many Walking Dead seasons does it take to ruin a network?
B. Why does Riverdale season 2 so bad?
I don't fit in, and I don't want to fit in.
And C. Is your IQ high enough to understand the complex humor of Rick and Morty?
Does evil exist? And if so, can one detect and measure it? Rhetorical question, Morty. The answer's yes, you just have to be a genius.
Without further ado, here's the interview.
I'm Vivienne Webster with LCCTV, and this is former alum Tracey Deer, who is a filmmaker and director.
I really credit the school for getting me where I am today, because they believed in my dream. And in life, you're going to meet a lot of people who don't always believe in the dream, who try to push you on different paths. And LCC got behind what I wanted to do and did whatever they could to just keep encouraging that. So that was fantastic.
Mohawk Girls, you've been working on the series for 6 years. And what's been the community reaction to the show? Because I know that you film on site, and so what's that like?
So it's very special to me to be filming in my own community. I mean, this is where I grew up making movies when I was 12 years old, and now I'm back in those same neighborhoods with a team of 70 people and millions of dollars being spent locally. In terms of the response back home, I think my biggest fans are in Kavanagh, but also my biggest critics are in Kavanagh. Some people don't like the show. They don't like what I'm putting out there. They say I'm making us look bad. And it's a difficult criticism to get, because I don't think I'm doing that. And my response to that criticism is, if you don't like what you're seeing that I'm putting out there, it's the truth. The show is based on the experience I lived. And so if we don't like what the truth looks like, then let's work together to do something about it.
Hitchcock, Scorsese, Coppola, all legendary filmmakers.
Their films have touched the hearts of people all around the world, and now we can add another person to their ranks.
For our next segment, we present to you one of history's most beautiful films, The L, presented by Mikey Baril.
Thank you.
one thing we at LCCTV love, that's respecting our veterans.
Here's a Remembrance Day video.
And today is important to stop, to reflect, and to mark the end of hostilities in the First World War in November of 1918, and to consider the sacrifice of previous generations in all major conflicts.
Grade 11 students will now recite the names of the 76 LCC alumni who gave the ultimate sacrifice during World War I, World War II, and the Korean War.
Ian Macmillan Crawford.
Charles Stewart Gibson Crowley.
John Terrence Joseph Davis.
Ellis George
Black. Vos mères vous pleurez dans leur chaumière close. Vos amantes ont dit leur peine aux gens du bourg. On a parlé de vous, tristement, tous les jours.
Real hero of Dunkirk was actually a Canadian from Montreal and a student here at LCC. In an effort to properly mark his memory and his exceptional achievement, the Canadian government erected a plaque in his honor this past September in Lachine, down by the water.
In Flanders fields the poppies blow, between the crosses row on row, that mark our place in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly.
I went to LCC and I left the school. My third son, Paul Rowan, or Paul Jr., is a third year officer cadet at the Royal Military College of Canada. So four generations of my family have served one way or another. So we are very, very proud of the military and Canada. Winston Churchill said the right thing. I'm going to paraphrase. The only thing it takes for the bad guys to win is if the good guys remain seated.
What is freedom to you?
I guess freedom is just, you know, being able to do and have your own thoughts in the world and be able to express them without having any repercussions.
What kind of things do you think the soldiers were feeling when they were going off to war?
Probably I'd say fear, you know, just like going in, you can lose your life at any moment, so I think fear would be a big factor.
How do you think their sacrifice helped shape the future?
I mean, well, right now we live in a free country, we have, you know, we have rights and all that, so I think a big part of our freedom right now is because of them, so that's pretty much it.
Ah, children, don't you just love them? Kids are the best. And did you know that LCC has its very own kids? Yeah, they're called kindergartners. Let's learn more.
Cookie?
Miss Cookie. Went down home. That was home bus and Miss Kay. I'm playing gym.
You like gym?
Gym. Because you get to run and you get to play. Painting.
Painting? You like painting?
Pizza.
You like pizza?
Pasta. Purple, the nice color.
Blue.
Coloring.
Coloring?
To work good. Play nicely. It's nice to be nice.
Another successful episode of LCCTV.
If you want to join the LCCTV production team, email any of us or Mr. O'Claire. Hitchcock, Scorsese, Coppola. All legendary filmmakers.
Coppola.
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 Francis Ford Coppola.
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 Coppola. Coppola.
The winner is Francis Ford Coppola for the Godfather Part 2.